up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. Hi, hello, how are we today? I'm sure you already read this YouTube title, but we are talking everything boobies. It's gonna be great. A lot of you know I got my breast augmentation about maybe 6 weeks ago. Kinda wanna give you some updates, my thoughts on it, what size, doctor, everything under the sun about it. So with that being said, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel and let's get started. To be honest, this is a very vulnerable thing to chat about because the internet can have really judgmental people, and honestly in life people can be judgmental. Tons of people make comments at me, but at the end of the day I'm gonna do what I want to do because it's my body, it's my life, I'm the only one living in it, and I'm so happy with my decision. But I know that a lot of people don't necessarily talk about plastic surgery online, and I want to normalize that you shouldn't shame people for them wanting to do something with themselves, even if you don't agree with it. At the end of the day, it's not their business and they don't actually know that person. So just keep that in mind. This is a vulnerable topic for me to chat about, and if you don't want to hear it or listen to it, click away. I have 100 other videos for you to watch. I guess where to even start? I knew since I was 18 I wanted to get a boob job. I mean, I loved my boobs prior. They were double A's. I never had a problem with it. I rocked all my halter tops. I was living in my low-cut dresses because there was nothing that was gonna fall out. But I knew at the end of the day, I did want a little perk up, and I knew that was something that I was going to get eventually. It was just, I always had wanted it. I did a lot of research. I started researching this when I was 18, so I got my boob job when I was 25. I'm a grown woman, and over the years, I definitely researched everything under the sun. I researched podcasts, YouTube videos, went to many consultations with doctors to get their opinion, chatted with girls that got them removed, chatted with girls that had them and loved them, researched breast implant illness. I did a lot of my research, so my first advice would be do your own research. At the end of the day, it's your decision, and there are so many opinions out there, and you've got to decide an opinion for you. You have to decide if that's good for your body. Also keep in mind that I am in no way telling anybody to get plastic surgery. I'm just telling you my experience because so many girls have messaged me recently just wanting me to go in detail. So instead of me responding to everybody, I figured why not just make a YouTube video. But just keep in mind, I'm not telling anybody to do whatever. I think natural bodies are beautiful. I also think that if people want to get plastic surgery, that's beautiful. I'm not one to judge about that. I could talk forever about this kind of stuff, but I did want to kind of go over my experience and what I really got. So when you go in for a consultation with a doctor, I probably went to 3 this past year when I knew, hey, okay, I have the means, I would really like to get this done, and I had done all my research and I felt comfortable. I felt like my pros outweighed all of my cons because this is a surgery and there are risks. So you do have to keep that in mind. So I started researching doctors that were near me. I wanted them in California. I didn't want to have to travel for this. I wanted to rest at home. So I went to 3 different ones right before I decided to get my surgery. I booked 2 doctors at first just to have a consultation. Sometimes you have to pay a fee. One doctor, I paid $250, and the other doctor was free. So it totally depends. I don't think anyone's good or bad. I don't know. And my girlfriends came with me to help me out. This was something I personally want to do. It's not like Michael has ever pushed me to do this. I did not do this for men. I did not do this for social media. I wanted this before I even knew I was going to be an influencer. I wanted to do it for myself. It is okay to want to do something like this for yourself. I feel like a lot of people assume you want it for like society or men, and like, no, sometimes you just want to do it for yourself. And girl, you do it for yourself if you want, okay? So I booked 2 appointments. What you usually do when you come with an appointment is you have photos, like inspiration of boobs, honestly. Like maybe you see an influencer and you like how it looks, and like I would show them and say, I would love that on my body. So my photos were a lot of natural looking breasts. I wanted something that just fit my body. I didn't care for it to look fake. I think some ladies pull it off and I think it looks amazing. I just wanted it very, very natural. I still wanted to be smaller because I still think smaller boobs are really good looking on my body. So I mostly found a lot of girls that were very natural, and I showed the first doctor. He was very intense about going big and like going bigger. And I just felt like that didn't resonate with what I wanted, especially I wanted natural and I wanted smaller. And maybe not a lot of women get that, but I just wanted a natural C. That's all I wanted. And just a little something to perk up, you know what I'm saying? I just felt like it wasn't a good fit. It made me uncomfortable. So ladies, if surgeons are doing that, no, I absolutely got bad vibes off that doctor. So then I went to another doctor who was known to be a bit more natural. The weirdest thing, it was around November. I was gonna book my appointment with him and his assistant would not call me back for the life of it. And it drove me bonkers. So I just thought this could be a sign that this doctor is not my fit, but I did like the doctor. I just couldn't handle the management and I wanted to be treated well. During these consultations, you basically say, hey, this is what I want. You show the photos. Some doctors let you try on implants. We put it in a bra and you can see what you looked like. It was hard to envision because it doesn't necessarily fit your body. It's gonna look different when it's actually in your body. I got like the general basis that I knew I wanted around 300 cc's. Now, it depends on your body type. 300 cc's could look really big on someone that's 5'1", and it could look really small on someone that's like 5'7". So once again, listen to your doctor and what they suggest, but I knew that was my range that I kind of wanted, and even 300 was making me a little too much, too anxious, so I thought, probably go less than 300. So that's the cc's that you choose. So basically your implant size. Then you choose what kind of implant you want. I went with a silicone implant. There's two different silicone implants and I went with the one that was a bit more expensive. And I can't remember the name of it, but my doctor recommended it and it's going to be a bit more firmer than some of the silicone, so they tend to hold up a bit more. But you can also do saline. It's totally up to you. I'm not gonna bore you with the information. Talk to your doctor and see what fits you best. And then third, you choose the profile you want. And a lot of ladies are like, what the heck does that mean? And there's a lot of misconception about profiles. Here's the list of some options, and it totally depends on what you want. There is round implants, there are teardrop implants, there's so many different implants. I knew I wanted a round implant, and I wanted moderate plus. Moderate plus was going to be a bit more natural, but they are still going to sit up. And if you have a smaller frame like me, you don't necessarily want the implant expanding. You want it a bit more condensed, and moderate plus was a very good middle ground where it'd make it look more natural. After those two doctors, feeling discouraged, and I was like, you know what? I'll just push it off. I'll wait till I find the perfect doctor. I went and I chatted with one of my friends. She was like, oh my gosh, a couple of my friends have gone to this doctor in Beverly Hills and they loved him. They had nothing but great experiences. And I was like, perfect. I wanted to know people that had gone to these doctors because I wanted to make sure it was a good experience. So check that off my list. I booked a consultation with him and I drove down to Beverly Hills with one of my friends and chatted, ticked everything for me. He had his own surgery center, so it was really flexible on when I wanted to get it done. I basically explained, hey, I really want natural. I want it a bit more smaller. These are things that not a lot of girls that get boob jobs do. And he was like, I completely understand. I can achieve this for you. From there, I went ahead and I booked it. A lot of people asked about price. It definitely depends on where you're located at. I know people that are in different states that pay $7,000, where in California, especially Beverly Hills, the more standard price was probably going to be between $8,000 to $12,000, $15,000, dependent on what kind of implants, what kind of doctor, all that kind of stuff. Mine ended up being around $11,000, but that was pretty standard from what I looked at other practices. But once again, totally depends on where you're located, so I can't speak for all of this. So I booked it and I was so stoked. I did a pre-op, which just means you go and get your blood drawn. They make sure nothing is wrong. They make sure to know your blood type. That way, if you ever need blood and surgery, just precautionary. I also got a COVID test. Then I met with my doctor again and we kind of just went over what I wanted. And he reassured me. A couple weeks prior to the surgery, you can't drink. I personally quarantined. I also couldn't take supplements. You can't smoke. I personally don't smoke, but people can't do that because it could interfere with you going into surgery. So then fast forward a couple weeks later, I was so stoked. I was also really nervous. I recorded this entire thing if you guys wanna go check it out. But basically to prep for it, I also bought like zip up sports bras because you can't really move for the first week. You want a sports bra that's gonna be easy to pop on. So I show up in my zipped up sports bra and I go back to a surgery center and I was shaking in my boots because I'd never had major surgery before other than my wisdom teeth removal. So they comforted me. We once again went over what I wanted. He was so helpful about that. I remember the nurse hooked me up with an IV and I do IV therapy, so I was like, oh, that's a piece of cake. And I walked over literally to the like bed that you lay on. They started to kind of wrap my legs up and put my arms out. I think they like kind of tie you up while you're under, which kind of sounds weird, but just so you don't fidget or anything. I actually have no idea. Guys, I'm not a doctor, but I just know I started getting nervous. So they gave me something to calm me down. once they gave me that, I was like, guys, let's go, let's go. So then I remember the anesthesiologist was like, all right, what are you gonna dream of? And I said mermaids, because do we know her anywhere else? No. And weirdly, I did not dream of mermaids. I dreamt of surgery in a good way. It was like, I think I was coming out of the anesthesia and like they probably were like moving me over to my bed to recover. I was thinking I was dreaming. Honestly, when you go under like that, remember with my wisdom teeth, it's gonna be like, night, night, and then you're awake. So that's kind of how I felt. And I woke up and I had a ton of pressure on my chest, and I also could feel stabs right here. I didn't go over this, so I guess this would be the fourth part, is they decide how to put the implant in. Sometimes you can go through the belly button, you can go through the nipple, you can go through under your boob. It totally depends on what you wanted. I wanted under my boob. There's so many different reasons on why you can do either one. Talk to your doctor. Do you see this reoccurring theme? Talk to your doctor, because you can only learn so much online about this kind of stuff. But I woke up and I felt these stabs and I was like, oh my gosh. And I talked to the nurse and I was like, make this go away. And she had given me pain meds. She was like, I can't make it go away like completely. In my head, I thought it could go completely. And she's like, you just had surgery. So I'm like, okay, good point. I was so nauseous from the anesthesia, and apparently if you are more prone to motion sickness, it might make you feel a little crummy. So that was probably the worst part, was feeling just uncomfortable with the pressure and like the cuts, and then being really nauseous. And you also, they have a tube down your throat when you're sleeping, and you don't feel it go in or anything. Honestly, I would never have even known I had it, but your mouth is really dry from the tube. So I was like, water. So she was trying to give me water, and after 40 minutes, I recovered. She called Michael. Michael pulled up the car and she wheelchaired me out and he took me home. It was about an hour drive, and bless his soul, because I was like, get me home, because I was so nauseous. So he played Taylor Swift for me, held my hand. That's what I do remember. I was very in and out of it. Had all my medications. You take an antibiotic for about a week after, just make sure everything's safe. And then depending on your doctor and depending on who you are and your pain tolerance, they can give you pain meds, or some people just do like Tylenol or something. Totally depends. I was in a lot of pain, so I took pain meds for maybe 3 days. Once I got home, Michael ordered me french fries because I was so nauseous, and the nurse had said, hey, if she eats french fries, it might help her. So he ordered me that, and I probably ate like three, and I finally fell back asleep. And once I was sleeping, I was a bit more comfortable. Honestly, the first 12 hours was probably the roughest. Wake up every 2 hours and just kind of readjust myself. You can't lie on your side or your stomach for a couple months, actually. So that was just me being uncomfortable, trying to get adjusted, because I'm definitely a stomach sleeper. Comment what you are, because I am like an avid stomach sleeper. Apparently sleeping on your back's healthier for you. I don't know if that's true, but I heard it. It makes me feel a little bit better. So after the first 12 to 24 hours, it started getting a bit easier. You definitely feel pressure in your chest and you feel heavy. Like, to sit up, Michael kind of had to help me, just because you feel like you have pounds on you almost. It's like you're getting a workout all over again. That eventually goes away. We took a lot of slow walks eventually. You can't get your heart rate up for the first 3 weeks, just because they don't want you to bleed. You can't, still can't have alcohol, still no supplements. So those next 3 weeks, I just took it easy. My friends helped wash my hair, because you are really sore right here for the first couple 4 days. After the fourth day, honestly, you can do whatever you want. You just have to be really careful, you know, go slow. I didn't pick up anything more than 5 pounds for about 3 weeks either, which, shout out to Michael, because he was a great house husband in that moment. I just was so appreciative that my friends cared. You know, my parents sent me flowers and my mom sent me this candle, and it was all so lovely and just made me feel really loved while I recovered. And after the first week, I went in for my post-op appointment. My doctors checked out my scars. He was like, hey, you're good to go. You don't need to wear zip-ups anymore, but keep wearing a sports bra, keep them protected, go slow, all that kind of stuff. I'll see you in a couple weeks. And then he taught me how to start massaging. I know this depends on who you are and your doctor. Some of my friends did it and some didn't, but he believes in massaging for about 15 minutes a day to make them a bit more natural and break up that scar tissue. Because at first, they're gonna sit really high. You're gonna be like, what the heck did I do? And they're gonna be really swollen. Mine were like looking like double D's on me. I was like, whoa, who is she? And that goes away. The swelling drops and your boobs slowly start to drop. It's actually called drop and fluff. So they're really high up first, and it's because your muscles are really tense. And then as your muscle relaxes and accepts the implant, essentially, which, once again, I'm not a professional, I could be butchering that, but this is what I understood, is it kind of loosens up they drop and then they fluff out. So they get a little bit bigger. At first they're really condensed. They're literally like melons on you. And you're like, wow, I look like a Barbie doll. But I promise you, it gets normal. They look more natural. I mean, this is 6 weeks and you can still tell they still sit up a little bit high. Your breasts actually don't fully form for a full year. So they're gonna look so different from 2 days to 1 week to 3 weeks. Literally, these things change every single day. It is a patience game. I think the biggest thing that nobody told me was you expect this instant gratification in the sense of I want to look like those girls that I envisioned, those photos that I show these doctors, and you're not gonna look like them. You are gonna look like yourself. Your body is gonna be different than theirs. So take that into account. If you are showing him a model that's 6'5 with perfect boobs, like, and you're 5'1, it's gonna be different. So take that into account. You wanna find a like-minded body and then one that fits your frame as well. So that was a huge, huge thing for me to have these days where they were really hard and I'd feel bad. And I think that's normal, honestly. I think that's completely normal because your body does change a lot and you're not gonna look like that at first. And honestly, you're probably never gonna look like that because your body is different. I was basing it off of some women that our bodies are completely different. And I promise you, it all works out, and trust the process and trust yourself. If a doctor is telling you to go bigger and you feel really uncomfortable, stick to your guns. I know for me, I was so adamant on my size, and I'm so, so thankful that I went a natural C and I, you know, didn't go pushed into one way, because I know that I wanted to be a bit more petite, and I love them. I absolutely love them. And so far they're healing great. I'm working out. After 3 weeks, I was able to start working out again. I'm definitely more conscious of using my chest. You can't use your chest for about 3 months. But after that, you're good to go. You can do push-ups, downward dog, whatever you wanna do. I've been doing a lot of leg days. I'll kind of isolate my muscles with my arms. I am so happy with my decision. And this was something I've been wanting to do for myself for so long. And it is the biggest thing I've ever done for myself. So it's even crazy to look back at photos before and then see now. I hope this video helped you guys. This is a vulnerable thing for me to talk about. Fully want to be transparent and honest with you guys because there's nothing fake in my life. Literally, what I film, what I do on Instagram is what I do every day and is my life. And I would never want to hide that from you. And I also want to normalize talking about this kind of stuff. And that's important to me. Comment down if you have any questions and I'll try my best to answer them. And oh, here's I guess the update. I'm wearing a shirt from Princess Polly. She'd be cute. But you can tell, like, I'm not wearing a bra right now. They're starting to move a bit more, but they're still like kind of stuck. If you look, like, some, you know, boobs move. Mine are still like, they're still pretty round and they're still pretty high up. But honestly, I love it. I'm so, 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 so happy with my decision. My parents, my family were all so supportive. My dad literally made a joke at Christmas and got me a bra because he knew I was getting it done soon. And even when I had told my dad, he was like, you've literally said you wanted this since you were young. Like, we knew you were gonna do this at one point. That about wraps this up. I hope you liked it. I hope it was helpful in some way. With that being said, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you next time.